Solubility. Solubility is how well things dissolve in something else. We have the solute and the solvent. The solute is the object or the stuff that goes into the solvent. And of course, water is the universal solvent. It dissolves a lot of things. All right, I always say you hide the SOL lute in the SOL vent. My students will know what I'm talking about. If you're not one of my students, then it's a long story. But anyhow, but you know, water's the universal solvent, and the solute goes into the solvent. Okay, anything that does the dissolving is the solvent. There's a few ways where you can increase the rate at which it dissolves, and it's all delicious jello here. All right, basically, if you heat the water more, it dissolves faster. And so heating the liquid will let it dissolve more. Stirring it will allow it to dissolve more as well. All right, so you stir your jello up. And then finally is grind it down into a fine powder. You give the particles more surface area for the water to attack. If you had a big brick of jello, it would not dissolve nearly as quickly as a powder will. And so grinding it down, that's why you grind down coffee beans or tea leaves or jello or sugar granules or anything. It dissolves much easier. So those are the three ways you make it dissolve faster. The other thing over here is solubility graphs. These show how much of the solute will dissolve in a solvent. And so, and we see down here, hey, as temperature increase, we just said there, as temperature goes up, it can dissolve more. And so that's what we see as temperature goes up. This is the amount of the material that will dissolve. It says solubility, all right, and is how many grams, these are the grams right here, per 100 milliliters of water. And a lot of students get this part confused here. You can kind of ignore that part. This is just the grams right here. Because what that is saying is, if I had 100 milliliters of water in this bowl here, all right, how many grams could I dissolve in there? Obviously, if I had, you know, 200 milliliters of water, I could dissolve more, or 300 milliliters. So it's setting the standard. Hey, I can only fill the bowl up this much. How many grams can I dissolve in this much water? So that's what that grams per 100 milliliters of water. That's what these are here. And so you just look at it along this line as I heat it up. Well, at 40 degrees temperature, I can dissolve about 60 grams of delicious jello mix into that bowl. And then if I heat it up to the boiling point of water at 100 degrees Celsius, I can get 250 grams of delicious jello mixture in there. And so the hotter you get, the more you win. That's called saturated. That's how much that water will hold. It below that graph is called unsaturated, meaning, again, say here at 100 degrees Celsius, it'll hold 250 grams. But if you only have 100 grams in here, this line right here, that point right there, if only at 100 grams, it's below what it can hold up here at 250. So that'd be called unsaturated. And then above the line is what they call supersaturated. And that's only under, you're like, well, how could it possibly hold more of the solute than it can hold? You know, it's like, how does that, under certain conditions, that is true. The most obvious condition is pressure. If you increase the pressure, you can squeeze and force it to hold more. Soda, for instance. Carbon dioxide, the gas, is a solute. You're dissolving the carbon. It's a gas, but it's still dissolved in the water, and it's made carbonated water. And under pressure, while you've got the cap on it still, it will stay in that solution. But the second you release that pressure, you pop the can. That's when the fizz comes out. That's when the carbon dioxide, it can't stay in there anymore because you've released the pressure. And so it goes from that super saturated solution and wants to fall back down to just that line there under normal conditions, the saturated line.